Good day, shooters! It's Rick from Canadian Rimfire Precision Series with a tabletop review of the Huckleberry Impact, the Rimfire Target Sensor from Nat Postma. Nat's been shooting CRPS for a couple of years now and decided to solve a problem that shooters and match directors face when they're shooting steel placed at very far away, over 200 yards, 250, 275. Typically, the steel is bigger so that we can see it, but unfortunately, when you get out to those ranges, the 40 grain or 36 grain, even the 42 grain 338 Lapua of Rimfire ammo, Ely Force, doesn't necessarily move the steel enough to be able to detect impacts reliably. Sometimes if you got freshly painted targets, you can see splash, but more often than not, you're kind of guessing, did it move, did it not move? So historically, we've been relying on some very effective, but unfortunately very expensive Magnetospeed T1000. So these are the ones we use. We've had probably five of these since year one, knowing that we had that issue. This year, Nat Postma sent us a couple of these to review. We were able to actually shoot this at the first CRPS match in Warren Field before the season came to an abrupt halt for everybody. And now we feel that since we put it out at far distances, we're able to provide some good solid feedback. What is the big attraction for this? Again, other than being able to see your hits, it's the cost factor. This is roughly half the price of the Magnetospeed T1000s. They're, I think the street price is about $100. You can get them from Nat Postma directly, huckleberryimpact@gmail.com. I'll put a link in the description after. You can also hit him up on Instagram at huckleberryimpact. And you can see that's ringing now. Again, it's built to a price point, which is $100. It's a standard case that he was able to source. It holds three AA batteries. It's got an on-off switch, and you can see it lighting up there. And you've got a function or a mode button. And a couple of the options, one is change the flash pattern. The second one is change the sensitivity, high, medium, low. We set it at high, and it worked pretty well. And I'll talk a little bit more about that. And the last mode is setup mode, which is basically constant flashing, and I'll just turn that on now so you can see kind of what that looks like. And the objective of that setup mode is for you to place this on your steel at distance and have a spotter say, hey, can you see it now? And then be able to aim this reflector. So unlike the Magnetospeed, which is using a rubber or plastic prism, this is using a metal reflector on an aluminum stock that you can bend. And it works. I mean, we put it out of steel at 185 and 275, and reliably both spotter and shooter could see that they were making hits. Again, the important thing is you've got to aim it, just like you have to aim with a Magnetospeed, you've got to aim it. We were shooting just above zero that day, and it lasted the whole day, so I'm not concerned about the battery life. All of the hits were pretty much indicated, and it's a solid solution. If you're looking for an effective and, more importantly, cost-effective solution, I would look at the Huckleberry Impact Rimfire Target Sensor from Huckleberry Impact. That's Nat Postma, who's the owner, operator, and engineer, designer, and shipping, packaging, all-around nice guy as well. So his email address is again, huckleberryimpact@gmail.com. Take a look, try it out.